Welcome to the Aloe Experience, where you can explore, unlock items, and experience mindfulness.
two more. Lower. Squat. Good morning. Stand. Last one. Good morning. Squat. range of motion in the bottom shoulder. Nice. Not letting the bottom shoulder crunch in. You want to keep tall spine, keep rotating the eye of the elbow forward on the bottom arm. Nice. Other side. Opening as much as physically can every time. Good. Last round. Open, close. Open, close. Last one. So the other side. Open, close. Reach. Yes. Last one. Nice. Next up, plank. Claw the earth with your hands. Release the knees from the earth, lifting them towards the sky. Squeeze the heels together. Press up out of the shoulders. Hold your plank. This is the best way to warm up your body, and you know it. Claw the earth. Maybe shift forward and back a few times. Hold here. Nice. For 3, 2, and 1. Maybe do a one-arm plank, yeah? Hold for 3, 2, 1. Other side. Shift the weight slightly. Hold. You got this. For 3, 2, 1. Good. Bend the knees. Send the hips back. And then come forward plank. Just like that. Bend the knees back. Opening the shoulders and the hips. Yes. The whole body should be starting to feel nice and warm. This is the perfect way to start any of these series. Starting with a stretch and mobility. And then stacking it with any of the fitness or more intense yoga classes. Try one of Koopas. They're absolutely insane. I'm always doing them behind the scenes because I love them. Good. Now in downward facing dog, pause here. Straighten the knees. So now you're in down dog. Take a down dog push-up. So the elbows go a little wide. Shift forward. Tap the knees. Nice. Send the hips to down dog. Push up. Shift forward. Tap the knees. Down dog. Push up. Nice. Just like that. Barely tapping the knees. Yes. Still igniting the core. Make sure you don't skip that push-up. If you want to double up that push-up, go ahead. We just have a few more here. Yee! Good. Give me 3 down dog push-ups. Yes. For 2 and 1. From down dog, take a nice slow walk to the top of your mat. I like staying on my tippy toes, really igniting the core. Shifting my shoulders over the fingers. Nice. Forward fold, shake the head, yes and no. And then slowly rise to standing until you get to the top. Nice. Take a nice little squat. Inhale, arch the back, stick the booty out, roll the shoulders back. We're rocking the pelvis in a squatted cat-cow. Exhale, round the spine, chin to chest, tuck the pelvis. Inhale, reach the shoulders through. Exhale, round. If it feels comfortable to flip your grip, you can do that. Inhale, reach. Exhale, round. A few more for 3. For 2. And 1. Then roll all the way up to standing. Cross the body, shoulder stretch, super simple, but do some wrist rolls on the shoulder you're stretching. Maybe sway side to side like I am, get some more movement involved. Keep squeezing and pulling the arm in, both your arms, working the shoulders. Other side, switch, roll, yes. Pull, wrist roll. You can do wrist rolls with both of your hands if you want. Nice. For 3, for 2. For 1, let's warm up the hips even more. Get the booty. Reach the hands up overhead. Exhale, good morning. Sending the hips back, legs straight. And then come into a squat, reaching the chest up, hands up. And then good morning. And stand. Exhale, lower. Good morning. Inhale, squat. Exhale, good morning. Inhale, stand. Nice, keep going. Booty back. Squat low, ladies and gentlemen. Back to that good morning. And lift. Good, 2 more. Lower. Squat. Good morning. Stand. Last one. Good morning. Squat. Good morning. Stand. Everything should be feeling nice and warm. Give me some skandhasana side to side. Tap elbow to knee. Booty goes back. Good. Side to side. right here. This is the last movement. Warm up the largest muscle group in your body, the legs, the thighs, get some blood flowing. Good, for 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful, you guys. 10 minutes is all it takes to warm up the entire body. And like I said, your body is so primed to work out, to yoga. So stack this class with one of the harder classes, yeah, because your body's ready. But wherever you are, I so appreciate you practicing with me. Namaste, Tani Janae. Hello, yogis. Welcome to Istanbul. We're in Turkey together for the next 10 minutes, flowing through a full body mobility flow. But I want to pause for a cause and tell you that just behind us is this natural border between Europe and Asia. It's the Bosphorus, and it's absolutely stunning. Just take it in for 1 minute, and then we're just going to get right into it. So this is a full body mobility flow. It's kind of like a stretch, but it's also kind of like a workout, but it's not too much of either, right? Yeah? Okay, cool. Lay on your back to start on the mat, taking turns, hugging one knee in, doing some ankle rolls, and then the other, just like that. Just back and forth, giving me some ankle rolls, a nice tug of the knee in, squeeze it in, open the hip, open the ankles, gentle, yes. A few more back and forth. Maybe start to breathe. That always helps, right? Awaken the muscles, get some fresh prana, some fresh life into your lungs. And now let's add the core, lift the chest, lift the bottom leg. They both do ankle rolls. Yes. Can you simultaneously roll both ankles? Mm-hmm. Yes, we can. Good. A few more. No big deal. For 3, 2, and 1. Heels down. I'm going to show you the difference between a yoga bridge and a fitness bridge. Roll the shoulders back for yoga. We like to lift the chest for yoga. We like to find this arch in the upper back, this lifting in the upper back, but I don't really want that. A slight untuck of the shoulders, pull and knit the front ribs to the back ribs. So you've got this nice, sexy, gorgeous line, spine, shoulders, hips to knees, yeah? Keep that and just little pulses up. Right here, warm up the butt cheeks. Act like you're slightly squeezing the knees together. So you're activating the inner thighs here. Yes, that's what we want. Good. Now lower all the way and lift. Now I don't want to see you arching your back like this and then lifting, squeezing. I want your whole freaking spine to lower and lift, keeping that axial extension, that perfect spine that we just worked out by squeezing the front ribs to back ribs. Good. Just a few more here. Lifting your hips up. Good. For 3, 2, and 1. Nice. I'm going to roll back so I have a little more space. We flow, lifting the hips up, coming up into a forward fold, and then reach. If the knees need to bend or if you can't really reach super far, that's okay. We're just finding a little bit of a hamstring opening. Lifting the hips up, reaching forward. Yes. Hips up, nice, and forward. Hips up, the knees can be bent. Working out the back body, the posterior chain as we fold forward, igniting the core to lift the hips up. Not too crazy about form, just lifting the hips super high, having some fun with it. Good. Remember to breathe. For 3, 2, last 1. Nice. This is more of an advanced mobility move, but if you don't have super open hips, you just take your fingertips behind you. You're simply making 90-90 in the lower body. If you know that you've got really tight hips and this isn't like your favorite thing to do, keep the hands back here so you have a little bit of support. But if you know you're open, lift the chest. I'm gonna face you. Lift the chest, hands up. You don't need your hands. 90-90, side to side. Finding a full rotation on each side. Twist in the middle, over to one side. Yes. Oof, things are cracking and popping and opening in my hips. That's what we want. I like it. Keep working out the hips. Good. From side to side. Oof, I like these little cracks. For 3, 2, and 1. Now that we're done with the hips for a moment, shoulders. Point the fingertips back, so I'm externally rotating you. Thumb out with both fingers. Scooch your booty cheeks towards your heels. That's going to start to really create some sensation in the shoulders. You can leave them on the floor, breathing, reaching, broadening across the chest, the nipple line, lifting the chin up. Hello, sun. Can you feel that vitamin D? If you want to take it up a notch, lift the hips, get crazy. Wherever you are, breathe. Keep rolling the shoulders back, offering the heart up and through, and breathe. Good. Stay here for the last 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Flip over in a quadruped position, hands on the earth. We're going to work the shoulder mobility. So bend one elbow, touch and tickle the ears. Lift up and lower. Tap your own elbow up and lower for 3 on one side. And then switch to 3 on the other side. Working range of motion in the bottom shoulder. Nice. Not letting the bottom shoulder crunch in. We want to keep a tall spine, keep rotating the eye of the elbow forward on the bottom arm. Nice. Other side. Opening as much as you physically can every time. Good. Last round. Open, close. Open, close. Last one. So the other side. Open, close. Reach. Yes. Last one. Nice. Next up, plank. Claw the earth with your hands. Release the knees from the earth, lifting them towards the sky. Squeeze the heels together. Press up out of the shoulders. Hold your plank. This is the best way to warm up your body, and you know it. Claw the earth. Maybe shift forward and back a few times. Hold here. Nice. For 3, 2, and 1. Maybe do a one-arm plank. Yeah. Hold for 3, 2, 1. Other side. Shift the weight slightly. Hold. You got this. For 3, 2, 1. Good. Bend the knees. Send the hips back. And then come forward plank. Just like that. Bend the knees back. Opening the shoulders and the hips. Yes. The whole body should be starting to feel nice and warm. This is the perfect way to start any of these series. Starting with a stretch and mobility, and then stacking it with any of the fitness or more intense yoga classes. Try one of Koopa's. They're absolutely insane. I'm always doing them behind the scenes because I love them. Good. Now in downward facing dog, pause here, straighten the knees. So now you're in down dog. Take a down dog push-up so the elbows go a little wide. Shift forward, tap the knees. Nice. Send the hips to down dog. Push up, shift forward, tap the knees. Down dog, push up. Nice, just like that. Barely tapping the knees. Yes. Still igniting the core. Make sure you don't skip that push up. If you want to double up that push up, go ahead. We just have a few more here. Yee! Good. Give me 3 down dog push ups. Yes, for 2 and 1. From down dog, take a nice slow walk to the top of your mat. I like staying on my tippy toes, really igniting the core, shifting my shoulders over the fingers. Nice. Forward fold, shake the head, yes and no. And then slowly rise to standing until you get to the top. Nice. Take a nice little squat. Inhale, arch the back, stick the booty out, roll the shoulders back, the pelvis. Inhale, reach the shoulders through. Exhale, round. If it feels comfortable to flip your grip, you can do that. Inhale, reach. Exhale, round. A few more for 3. For 2. And 1. Good. Roll all the way up to standing. Cross the body, shoulder stretch, super simple, but do some wrist rolls on the shoulder you're stretching. Maybe sway side to side like I am, get some more movement involved. Keep squeezing and pulling the arm in, both your arms, working the shoulders. Other side, switch, roll, yes. Pull, wrist roll. You can do wrist rolls with both of your hands if you want. Nice. For 3, for 2, for one. Let's warm up the hips even more. Get the booty. Reach the hands up overhead. Exhale, good morning. Sending the hips back, legs straight. And then come into a squat, reaching the chest up, hands up. And then good morning. And stand. Exhale, lower. Good morning. Inhale, squat. Exhale, good morning. Inhale, stand. Nice, keep going. Booty back. Squat low, ladies and gentlemen. Back to that good morning. And lift. Good, two more. Lower. Squat. Good morning. Stand. Last one. Good morning. Squat. Good morning. Stand. Everything should be feeling nice and warm. Give me some skandhasana side to side. Tap elbow to knee. Booty goes back. Good. Side to side. Right here. This is the last movement. Warm up the largest muscle group in your body. The legs, the thighs, get some blood flowing. Good. For 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful, you guys. 10 minutes is all it takes to warm up the entire body. And like I said, your body is so primed to work out, to yoga. So stack this class with one of the harder classes, yeah, because your body's ready. But wherever you are, I so appreciate you practicing with me. Namaste, Tani Janae. Hello, yogis. Welcome to Istanbul. We're in Turkey together for the next 10 minutes, flowing through a full body mobility flow. But I want to pause for a cause and tell you that just behind us is this natural border between Europe and Asia. It's the Bosphorus.
Hi, and welcome to the Allo Experience on Roblox. I'm going to walk you through a simple and easy guided meditation session. For the next minute, we'll be working on a few breathing exercises. Let's begin. Let's start by finding a comfortable seat and taking a deep breath in. Count to six as you inhale, and allow the belly and chest to expand. Pause for a moment, and slowly begin to release the breath through the nose. Notice how the belly and chest slowly collapse as you gently breathe out. When you're ready, begin to breathe in deeply on the count of six, and gently let the breath flow through the nostrils as you exhale. One more time. Deep breath in. And when you're ready, slowly breathing out. Thank you for sharing your practice with me today. I hope you're feeling more connected to the present moment.